And joining us now here at the ABS-CBN International Headquarters is correspondent TJ Manotoc. Hi, TJ.
Hi, Jill. How are you?
TJ, you will be covering the NBA Finals between the Golden State Warriors and Cleveland Cavaliers. What are sports experts saying about this matchup? Which team has the edge and which is the underdog?
Well, so far, what I've been reading, observing, and from the other sports writers I've been around the last couple of days, the sentiment is split. Although I'd say that a little bit more than majority is leaning towards the Warriors because they are the number one seed. They have home court advantage. They've been playing better team basketball. But you just cannot count out the Cavs because of a guy named LeBron James. I mean, he is the guy with two championship rings. This is his fifth straight finals appearance. So in terms of experience, he has what it takes to lead his team all the way. So given that, we're guaranteed to have an exciting series, something that's going to go six or seven games deep, and we're not so sure who's going to take it all away.
TJ, sa mga Pilipino namang nakausap mo, mas kaninong team sila boto?
Hati din, Jelle. I mean, from back in Manila, and even to some of the Pinoys I've met here, I've seen people who are rooting for the Warriors. I've seen Pinoys rooting for the Cavs. In fact, one of the most amazing stories was a security guard who knocked on my window before I left, a couple of days before I left. He goes, I thought I was wondering what his problem was. He goes, boss, kaya ba ng Cleveland? Para kay LeBron ako. I mean, the regular Joe, the regular Pinoy back home, they're really, really excited to see this series. And hati din sila. There are a lot of LeBron fans and there are a lot of Warriors fans as well.
Okay, pag-usapan natin yung sinasabi mo, yung mga superstars ng bawat team. Mm-hmm. LeBron James of the Cleveland Cavaliers has visited the Philippines. Now, how did our Kababayans respond to him during the visit?
Oh, they were just so excited to see him. I mean, the moment it was announced, and then the moment that they said tickets were going to be released, although it was for free, they didn't sell the tickets, the line just for the tickets was incredible. They lined up more overnight. They lined up in the rain. I was there to cover the lineup like a day and a half before they released the tickets, and it was just incredible. It was more than the anticipation for when Kobe Bryant used to visit the Philippines, and it was just insane. He packed the Mall of Asia Arena, every single event he went to, it was just overflowing with people. So even though there was a little bit of, the usual Laker fans, alam naman mga Pilipinas, very Laker-centric din sila because of Kobe Bryant, they still came out to support LeBron James. He was the best player in the world at that time. He was at his peak, and they were just so happy to see LeBron. So he was a big hit in Manila.
Now, aside from playing in the San Francisco Bay Area, where there are so many Filipinos, diba, why do Kababayans like Steph Curry?
You know, I think the thing with Steph Curry is he reminds us of the Pinoy basketball player. He's not too tall, he doesn't jump so high, but his skills and abilities are just off the charts. And it's something that's very entertaining for the Pinoys. I mean, para sa mga kababayan natin who remember back in the day, Bernie Fabiosa, Sonny Jaworski, you know, all those guys who used to be the point guards who were very flashy, very entertaining to watch. I think that's how we can relate to a guy like Steph Curry again. And he's just also a kid who anybody can be. I mean, he's a guy who was just really a hardworking kid. He worked on his skills. He's not just God-given talent like LeBron James, who's 6'8", 250 pounds. He can jump out of the roof. That's a different story. Those are rare breeds. But Steph Curry, anybody can be like Steph Curry, but you have to put in the work. And that's what he's done. And that's why he's so entertaining and endearing, I think, to a lot of the Pinoys.
Ayan, at talagang aabangan ng mga kapamilya natin ang mga report mo dito sa NBA Finals. Maraming salamat sa iyo, TJ Manotoc.